On this episode of Innovation Ambassadors, we're showcasing the journey of Experian, a leading global information services company providing data and analytical tools to clients around the world. We'll explore their work with the AWS Innovation team in Australia on harnessing the power of the AWS Cloud to create better brand experiences for their consumers. Well, I'm excited to welcome from Experian, Marcio Goncalves, Head of Product Development. Marcio, thanks so much for being here today with us.
Thank you. It's good to be here.
And also from Experian, we have Joe Kennedy, Engineering Leader. Joe, thanks for being here.
My pleasure. Thank you for having me.
And joining us from AWS, we have Jesse Mulvogue, who is the Senior Account Manager in our Enterprise Greenfield segment based in Melbourne, Australia. Jesse, thanks for joining us.
Great to be here. Thanks.
So Marcio, for our international listeners, maybe you can tell us a little bit about what Experian does.
Sure. Experian is a global information services company. We work in Australia with their marketing services unit, and we help brands create better experiences to their own consumers. So, and obtaining value from data is where we particularly enjoy helping our clients, whether it's enhancing their data sets or providing insights to help drive their marketing dollar further. So that's who we are.
Wonderful. And what was some of the challenges that led you to work with AWS?
That's an interesting one. When we started a few years ago, we were pretty much working on like old school environments. So it was like databases, SQL Server environments where people just like query the data, not in the most of efficient ways. And the experience for our clients, we deal with data. So we have to process data. Everything was very manual, including the deliveries, which was not the greatest of the experiences. Everything was a file being sent over to a client to ingest in their own databases, which presents its own difficulties and the scalability issues that come with them, not only for us, because everything is manual, not scalable, but also for our clients, which had sometimes a difficulty ingesting the results of what we do for them.
Sure, yeah. And Joe, maybe you can set a little bit of that technology landscape for us and where you were trying to go.
Sure. So as Marcio mentioned, when he and I joined this team about 4 years ago, it was all on-premise SQL servers, lots of manual work, lots of undocumented stored procedures, and it was a very legacy landscape. Over the past few years, we have moved over to a cloud-first mindset. We're now dealing with data in vast volumes compared to what we had previously. And we're able to do that now because the cloud gives us that scalability, gives us that processing power that we just didn't have with the previous systems.
Mm. And so building that additional scalability in and looking at ways to automate those more manual processes was one of the challenge here.
Absolutely. Automation of processes and automation of maintenance as well. I'm sure you can imagine lots of on-premise servers. There's a big effort just to keep those updated with things like security patches, you know, mind doing anything really interesting. Now moving to cloud, moving away from servers to a serverless mindset, it really frees up our time to do the fun stuff.
Yeah, absolutely. So Jesse, maybe take us from there. Marcio comes to you with this pretty complex challenge that he's trying to address for the business. Where did you go from there?
So I think we really needed to understand the problem more deeply. At Amazon, we do things a little bit differently. So it's our job to go where there's ambiguity and really help the customer test ideas and try and help drive clarity. It seemed like working
Absolutely.
Backwards would be a great mechanism for that.
Yes, for sure. So that working backwards mechanism that we use internally, we also share with our customers, don't we?
Yeah, 100%.
So maybe talk through a little bit about how you brought that working backwards mechanism into a workshop, as I understand
sure,
it.
Sure, yeah? Sure. So We got together with the innovation team, gathered a number of experience experts in their team, so people that understood their customer deeply, which involved a number of stakeholders and calendarizing that. We had people from marketing, data engineers, and analytics. And working backwards is just a great mechanism because it makes us focus on the end customer and you know, workshop ideas, but also just walk in their shoes.
Absolutely. Developing that empathy for our end customer. And Marcio, as I understand it, that was really important to you to like have that customer-centric approach to the solutions you were trying to drive for your business. Is that right?
Absolutely. It's perhaps one of the top points, having this customer-centric approach and clarity of vision, I'd say, comes right in seconds. In Experian, we do so many things and we try... And we try to solve a problem for our clients in the best way possible. And we have such a wide and diverse set of opinions about how to do it that it sometimes it creates misalignment and people will have different ways to land on a solution for our client. I think working backwards helps us or forces us to be on the same page, which in the end streamlines the development work.
So how was that experience for you? Talk us through a little bit about what that workshop was like and what came out of it.
I think in a nutshell, we wanted to make our clients' experiences smoother. We deal with a ton of different data sets from our clients, ours, products. We to try helping the clients get value out of their data. And like I said, usually we will send files out to our clients, but that's not the easiest way for them to use. And plus this way we don't get to see how they use it and we don't get to see how they figure out what the parts they like and perhaps the most important, the parts they don't like. So we don't have insight over the experience. So we were on a mission, not just to fix the experience, but also to make sure it was user-friendly and helpful to who was using it in the end.
Yeah, absolutely. And that it was something that could scale to across the world, yeah?
I think it's definitely, it's like if the client is happy about it, if you can measure, if everybody's on the same page, scalability becomes kind of a consequence.
Then the next step was to actually write all this and clarify our thinking in a press release. Is that right?
Yeah, that's correct. We wanted to have everybody on the same page. I think not only the press release helped with that in putting what was the vision, what we're trying to achieve, but also the how. Like the press release is incredibly useful. I think for me the most important part was actually the FAQ, which forces people to spend energy in answering the right questions, answering the difficult questions ahead of time. So everybody like is forced into the same page, is forced to be on alignment. They understand deeply the problem to be solved. And most important, what's the right tool set to solve that problem.
Right, right. So the press release, very aspirational, setting that vision. And then the frequently asked questions, getting to the driving clarity of vision.
It kind of expresses, like, doing the PR FAQ before the product release expresses the concept of working backwards quite strongly, because
yes.
Usually a yeah. frequently asked question is something that happens in the future, whereas we actually did it in advance. So you're really
Absolutely.
Thinking through what that experience is.
That's right, Jesse, and I really love the same is true of the press release, right? We actually write the press release before we write any code, as if something, we put ourselves in the future and in the shoes of our end customer, and try to express the value as it relates to their experience, right?
Absolutely.
So we have this PR and FAQ. What's the next step, Jesse, in the journey?
So the next step was really just to get everyone together for the data discovery workshop. It's an opportunity for us to map out the universe of data sources for Experian. And again, Experian were very involved, I think we had four or so from their team and three from AWS. And it just gave us an opportunity to understand what we would do in the next stage, which is designing and architecting a build for a deeper data discovery workshop.
So, Joe, maybe you can take us through the architecture, the high-level architecture that came out of this workshop.
Sure. It is this self-service data delivery API, and that is API gateway at the front, a bunch of Lambda functions behind it, DynamoDB for the metadata storage, and then for the actual file delivery, one of those Lambda functions calls out to Snowflake, which is our data warehouse, based on the configuration that's been selected. The data then gets unloaded to S3 and is served back to the client via a pre-signed URL.
And that architecture, Marcio, allowed you to create a system that your customers could interact with. Is that right?
Yeah, not only that, but achieved the scalability we always wanted. The clients can come and interact with it without us having to intervene and piece data together in a manual way. So they just can come in and select the layout they prefer, what they want from the data. It was just so much easier to handle, which gave us these extra capacity to implement, like create improvements, create more behind the scenes instead of maintaining existing.
Right. Now, we often talk in this podcast about experimentation, also sometimes having failures in it, right? Sometimes it wouldn't be an experiment if we knew what the outcome was, right? There's always challenges along the way. Maybe there was something here that you'd want to share with our listeners.
Yeah, curiously, the outcome of this working backwards session was not put in production straight away. But that pivoted a number of other projects in which we used the same methodology, and they are in production right now. And we are using the same framework to go about the problem, to solve it, to get people alignment, and to build. And basically, the Experian team fell in love with the methodology because it achieves clarity in an environment where you have a diversity of opinions. It really helps us streamline and focus on one problem at a time. Not to mention, it allows us to like build fast and fail fast if needed.
And so, that ambiguity, bringing clarity to ambiguity, right, with the process. So what was the stumbling block or challenge that you had experienced?
We've been for years selling solutions that involve manually taking clients' data and helping them and then sending a file back to them. So the whole process is very manual or used to be very manual. When we introduced an API in the middle, people were just not ready to sell it or to talk about it to their clients. And enablement was a challenge. How do you enable your go-to-market team on talking about this one with their clients? And it made us realize that we're fast. We're faster than we ever been. And that one was provided as a learning on how to do the next one, which was much better. We involved the teams that we missed on the first time, and we did it again, and that one came out right. But it made us realize how faster we can move and how faster we can learn.
Right. I love that iterating on an approach that looked very promising, but then... And we often talk about this, don't we, Jesse, in the working backwards process, that it's an iterative process. We test and validate and then improve, right?
Test and validate to try to help drive clarity, and people and culture are often the challenge. Something that I'm just thinking of while I'm sitting here is that, you know, maybe we could have like another workshop at some point where we focus on that next challenge, which is, you know, sales team enablement and how to help them pick that up and, you know, wrap their arms around our experience and then how they can better improve their experience of their customers.
Absolutely. So Marcio, what's next? Sounds like you've deployed several systems into production and continuing to iterate and improve.
Yes. After the first session, the first working backwards discovery and the builds, we built probably another couple of projects that are already in production. We're going to embark on another one right next. So for us, it's a matter of like keep learning, iterating. I think this first one opened a path for so many projects, and it gave us this like speed that we needed, and this scalability. So I think for us next is we want to expand this methodology across our units, across the company, hopefully, and get them to benefit from this in the same way we did.
Wonderful. And Joe, on your side, that pattern, that architectural pattern that you established in that first data discovery lab, that's something that you're using and replicating in other systems, is that right?
Yeah, absolutely. We have another API in production, which has a fairly similar architecture. And we've also taken elements of that pattern into a new feature, which we've just gone live with in another product.
Great. Well, Marcio, Joe, and Jesse, thank you so much for being here today and sharing your story with us. And I'm just wondering if you had any words of wisdom or reflections that you would want to share with our listeners. I'll start with you, Jesse.
I think from an AWS perspective, I think it's important to set that expectation that a workshop like working backwards and data discovery does take time. When you want to work on a problem and really spend some time diving deep into that abyss, it can be a scary place to go. It's important to have a high level of trust so that you can really try to deliver the outcome that you're looking for.
Absolutely. Joe, how about you? What were your key learnings?
My biggest takeaway from this project is just how fast you can build transformative product if you're given the space to focus on it and the right tooling. I've been with Experian for 15 years now, and we have never built products as fast as we have done in the last couple of years. It's really amazing.
Fantastic. Love the power of getting rid of the undifferentiated heavy lifting, letting the cloud take care of that, and you and your team able to focus on providing value to your end customers. Yeah. Marcio, final words for you.
Well, I second what Jesse and Joe said. I think it's a matter of trust. We need to set the expectations correctly that whatever you're doing might fail. But if it fails, you learn a lot through it and you do it fast. In such a way, it's an iterative process. It's not a closed-ended loop in the end. And focus, absolute, undisputed focus in what you're doing. It's imperative, and it gets you there. It answers these questions fast. It's not a low energy process. You put a lot of energy, but the rewards are well worth it.
Absolutely. And Marcio and Joe, I know your experience all about creating a better tomorrow. Good luck to you on the all of the work that you'll do on behalf of your customers. And thank you all for being with us today.
Thanks, Sarah.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank our listeners for coming on today's journey with us. Look for future episodes of our podcast on your favorite podcast platform. Share your ideas for future episodes or comments on this one via the email in the description. Thank you.